Steve, top of League One, congratulations, but I'm sure you would much rather have done it with a win.
I've got no interest in top of League One. We played very well today. We gave away two of the worst goals that a team can concede, and a team deserving of nothing get a share of the spoils. So that dressing room is flat, and they'll stay flat because we need to learn. And we do learn, win, lose, or draw. And despite a good performance, individuals have to take responsibility for when we praise them. And they're lucky tonight because I won't name them, but it's two shambolic pieces of defending.
So your defence at fault rather than an offside for the first one?
Did I say your defence?
No.
But wasn't a defender conceded the second one?
Right.
Have a look.
The first one's suspicion of offside?
It is offside.
Right.
But the goalkeeper should then deal with it, shouldn't he? Right. Goalkeeper's Philip back in Sainsbury's from here. So he should deal with it. But he's a young goalkeeper that we think highly of, and he'll learn from that, I'm sure.
But, I mean, you stuck at it, given the conditions in the second half. Chance after chance.
Off the line, hitting the woodwork. Was it Jimmy, you get two, you take some plaudits, but you should have five or six.
Yeah.
That's not the standards that you need at this level of the game, or we win the game. So, but we're hot tonight, and we will hot. No plaudits from me being top of the league. With people all around, you've got games at hand, so I don't listen to that nonsense. That was before me, that nonsense.
It's obviously the same for both sides. How much of an influence was the temperature today?
No. Absolutely no. We're 1-0 up. If we get the second, we win here by as big a margin as we possibly have won this season. I think we just needed the second goal, and then we're a shambles, giving away a goal, and then it gave the Carlisle lads some oxygen when they were struggling to find any, not just because of the heat, because of our performance. And then I think second half, listen, apart from the odd ball over the top, I think it's domination, isn't it? chance after chance, and entry into the final third, and we make some clear-cut chances. I think I look at the first half, McBride should score, Reid should score. Look at the second half, Pierre Janney's unlucky. Reid should score two more. Kid Emming should score. Okay, keep going, Gunnar. I don't see them missing any chances.
I mean, their keeper's had a great game, in fairness, one of yours from last season, but obviously you will feel they should have been stuck in.
Well, Big Yogi never done that for us. But he's a great lad. He's a very enthusiastic lad. I'm not pleased for us, but I'm pleased for him because he had a broken arm when he left us. And he's gone away and he's bounced back with a really good performance. But we can't miss the level of guiltiest chances that we missed today. It doesn't matter who's in goal.
I'm quick on Pierre Gianni. That was also an ongoing issue. What, just a cut under the chin?
Yeah, just a cut under the chin. Just a little elbow on his chin. That's allowed. Mm-hmm. That's allowed in the game, isn't it? You know, he's allowed to be manhandled all over the pitch and he doesn't get anything going in his favour. So, but he's a warrior and he'll certainly lead us next week, subject to nothing happening ill toward in the week.
Thank you.